in life, we need to gravitate towards things that make us happy. And there's certain things in life that will naturally make you happy, right? If you're born with the gift of being able to paint or draw and being an artist, you will generally have bliss and happiness when you are painting, because that is your true nature. So I think all of us musicians that are out there, every single one of us, our true nature is to play music. We're tapped into that frequency. It's part of our lives. It's woven into our spirit. You know, it's in our culture. We share it with our friends and our family. We're moved by it. Not everyone is moved by music, but a lot of people can also be moved by music and say, I love listening to music. This is my favorite song. And they will go to a happy place when they hear that song, even though they can't play a note on any type of instrument. When they hear their favorite song, they can close their eyes and put their head back and they are in another place, just like we are when we go to a gig and we play. It's like virtual reality, because when you're on that stage and you're performing, you're not thinking about anything else except exactly being present in that very moment, that beat within that measure of that part of the song, right?
Right. Sure.
So same thing if you're a music fan and you're listening to music, right? You're captivated by it. You're in it. You're passionate about it. You love it. You know, it's something that is innately we're born with. And if you're fortunate enough to have a talent that allows you to actually play an instrument, it's really your duty to develop that talent to the best of your ability. And those that succeed, I think, the most in doing that are the people that are most inspired and have the most passion about what they do. Because if you don't have passion about something, it's going to fade away. And life is so short, you're wasting your time, right? So then someone would say, okay, but yeah, I play in this band, and why do I keep doing it week after week? Long hours, it's crappy pay. I got to pick up and load stuff in and out. But we do it for the couple of hours that we're on stage, right? And when we used to break it down, you'd say for the 3 or 4 hours you're on stage, you're 3 or 4 hours getting there and coming from, you know what I mean?
Right.
All together, packing up at home, loading up, driving there, unloading, getting on stage, sound checking, getting everything together, play. End of the night comes, break it all down, pack it all up, drive it all home, get back home and either unload it then or unload it the next day. When you add up all the time, it's a lot of hours tapping into that frequency, and it's just easy. You know, like I said, you get in the zone and you just channel your talent. You know, you're not thinking about what you're doing so much. You know, we've all been there. It's not every single gig, but the more you, you know, play, the more likely you are to experience it.
The power and magic of music, the goosebumps when the ego is shed and the music takes over. Let the music play the band. Magic.
Yeah, and it's important that the ego is shed, because it blocks your flow. Ego is a big obstacle to prevent you from getting into the flow.